Time to come clean.
Time to give the story up of the monkey breakfast.
This has been going on for months. We've been getting your emails every single day. We get an email about information on the monkey breakfast.
Here's how it all started. When Bri's new to Austin, so she was looking for stuff to do. And we were suggesting some things for her to do. And we got this call. Hey, Kim.
This is a great fun. It's a good Texas thing to do. If you go down to the Austin Primate Zoo, you can have a chuck wagon breakfast with the monkeys, and they dress them up like little cowboys.
Yeah, they put little hats on them.
I love that.
You like monkeys?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, you're going to love this.
So fun.
Do they come near you?
Oh, they're reading breakfast on the table with you.
They sit right there. You eat breakfast with them.
Yeah, you sit right there.
Where is that?
It's down at the Austin Primate Zoo.
That is amazing.
It's like a huge, like picture a big table like in the dining hall in Harry Potter.
Yeah, it's like that. It's
Hogwarts.
So fun.
Yeah.
And it's like a little chuck wagon. And they have a like a poo tossing contest.
But not at you, Bri.
They do that after
you look on. Yeah.
On the playground.
It's the dry kind. And
dung.
You throw it. Yeah. Anyway, it's really fun.
I went to this about 3 years ago, and one of the monkeys started eating the dung. I was like, okay, I've had enough. I gotta go.
You can't miss it.
The primate.
You don't have to do the poo part.
No,
that's fun and games later. But you can't miss it. It's the huge building, the Sigourney Weaver Center.
That's right. It is the Sigourney Weaver Center. I forgot about that. Thank you, Kim.
She donated that.
You're welcome.
Yeah, Sigourney Weaver donated all the money for the Primate Zoo.
Wow.
It is a world class facility, and people come in from all over the world to see it and to study the primates that are there.
Is that all monkeys?
Yeah,
pretty much. They got orangutans, too.
That's so much fun.
They got the red-ass monkeys. You ever seen those?
No.
The ones with the red butts?
No.
The baboons?
No. Aren't they big, though, baboons? Mm-hmm.
Yeah, baboons are big and strong.
I just want to cuddle with them.
Yeah, they'll cuddle with you.
They will?
And get a girl, because most of the boys are horny dogs.
The baby ones?
Yeah. They have a
like,
monkey
they'll hump you?
Do you know any sign language? A little bit?
I know that one.
Because they do. You can do some sign language with some of them that they've taught.
Amazing.
That's exciting.
I don't know if you've ever seen that.
Incredible. Well, have fun. There's
Thank
a lot
you.
Of stuff to do this weekend.
Oh, how long ago was that?
It's been a few months.
It's been several months.
We've been just, our mailbox, our inbox is full of requests for information.
A couple last night at 1 a.m.
About the Primate Center. You want to tell them?
It's all made up.
What?
It's all bull.
Yeah.
That listener Kim made it up.
And we
rolled
with it.
And then we just went with it.
It is complete bull.
And I know there's tens of thousands of people out there listening. They're like, I knew it was a lie the whole time. Well, we had set it up as a lie. Right. You went to go get some food next door, Bri, and we were like, hey, Bri will believe anything. Call and make stuff up of stuff to do this weekend. And Kim, who's an amazing liar, just called in and started made that up. And then we just started rolling with it.
So everyone that has emailed wanting to have their kid's birthday party at the Sigourney Weaver Primate Center.
Sigourney Weaver. Gorillas in the mist. Come on. You get it. Jeez.
It is complete.
If you tried to find the place, if you put any effort into finding it, give us a call.
Yeah.
Our number's 390-5947. We want to hear your story.
I don't know if now, but there was a thing on the Austin Zoo website with our link to it saying we have nothing to do with the Sigourney Weaver Primate Center.
Call Jamie and Sandy.
Yes, and put our hot phone, the 390-5947.
If you had a coworker who was convinced this was real and you tried to tell them otherwise, we would love to hear from you. It's 390-5947.
Dana at the front desk.
She believed it?
Bombarded with phone calls.
Remember the guy that called about showing your teeth?
Yes.
It was Andre that wrote to us, and he writes, he's like, I can't stress enough to be careful when you show your teeth. It's a sign of aggression, and the monkeys go crazy. Guys, we made the whole thing up. You bought it. You heard half the story. It's
feel bad for the moms. Yeah,
someone just
kids.
Here's what the Austin Zoo website says.
It verbatim. Still says it.
Yeah, it says the Sigourney Weaver Primate Center breakfast mentioned on the JB and Sandy show on 94.7 FM is not associated with the Austin Zoo. Please contact 94.7 FM and the JB and Sandy show directly for more information at 390-5947.
And Angela, hello. Is that what you wanted to tell us?
Yeah, that's exactly it.
Yeah.
I was going to take my daughter to the zoo, and I looked on the website, and I could not believe half of Austin must have bought the story. And it just cracked me up. I showed all my friends. I was like, you have got to see this.
Well, we couldn't believe how gullible Bri is, but it turns out half the city is fairly gullible, too.
Yeah, that's what surprised me. I mean, it was a great story. Y'all really... Y'all are really good liars, I gotta say.
We were just making it up as we went.
Yeah, we were.
I mean, well, it was good. Even I like the Longhorn jersey. That was nice.
Yeah, on game day. On game day
this morning.
On game day, they dress them up. Yeah.
Yeah, I love it. Love it.
They put on their little Longhorn jerseys and watch football at the Primate Center.
They fight for Colt McCoy's number.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I want to talk to
you. Gotta say, Bree's gotta feel. Somewhat okay, knowing that so many people were.
Oh, yeah. For sure.
Thanks, Angela.
All right. Thank you.
I want to hear from some people who went to great lengths to find this place.
I think Tracy may have. Hi, Tracy.
Hello.
What's up?
That just is not right whatsoever.
What do you mean?
I cannot believe y'all lied about that. That it was not a good joke.
Did you spend some time looking it up?
I spent time looking it up. I went to I don't know how many different websites, and now I have to figure out what the hell I'm going to do for my daughter's 13th birthday.